I want to show you guys a setup that I've been using for long time lapses. There's a GoPro, of course, and it's in the frame, and it's mounted using my belt mount that I've got in another video. And this is a long camera cord. It's got a mini USB on one side, runs down to a standard USB down here. This side of the USB cord is plugged into a cigarette lighter adapter. It's a USB charger that you might use in your car to charge your cell phone. They come in different amperage ratings. This is a half amp charger, and it's not really powerful enough. You really should get one that has a full 1 amp to each USB port. That's plugged into a 12 volt adapter, and the other end of that is just alligator clips to a battery, so that gives you a ton of capacity. Again, here are the components that I use for these long time lapses. On the left, you can see the 12 volt adapter. This goes from the battery to a cigarette lighter. It's made by Atwood, and I got it at Walmart for $5.44. You find it in the marine section, which is usually near the sporting goods. And I would imagine that not all Walmarts carry this, so you may just want to check. The cigarette USB adapter, the auto charger that I have is a half amp, and it really doesn't totally keep up with the demand of the camera. After a 10-hour stint of shooting, the internal battery is partially discharged. I would recommend that you get a auto charger that has a 1 amp USB output. Make sure that 1 amp is not divided between two outlets. You want the full 1 amp going to each USB port. The longer USB cord is just one that I had from a camera. You may or may not need a longer cord. The GoPro cord will work just fine, but it just happens to be short. The housing is the frame. That's what I use because that's what I have, and I like the frame. You just need a housing that will hold the camera and allow you to plug in the cord at the same time. The waterproof housings obviously don't have a hole right there, so you can't plug the cord in. GoPro also sells the skeleton housing that would allow you to plug in the cord also. And I have seen guys modify their waterproof housing with a waterproof pass-through for the cord so that you could leave it outdoors for an extended period of time. A car-style battery will obviously last for a long time, but they are kind of cumbersome. Obviously they're heavy and take up a lot of room. If you don't want to use a car battery, you can plug the USB end of your cord into an external battery pack. They make these power packs that are usually rectangular. They look kind of like a hard drive size, but they come in different capacities, and they're usually, you know, from $20 to $50, and that would, if you get a large one, it would probably last for a full day. But if you're gonna shoot for much longer than a day, you may want to go with the car battery. The location that I'm currently shooting this time lapse at is not a secure site. It's a construction site that I'm concerned about the GoPro, so I don't want to leave it there overnight. I took the first set of images and I printed out one, and then I used the GoPro app, and when I set up the camera in the morning, I compare what it's shooting on the app to the picture, so you can kind of match it up and make sure your setup is in the same spot. I leave the belt mount on the tree that it's set up on, and I try to leave the mount on the camera set at the same angle, so you should be able to match it up fairly well. Ideally, you would leave the camera always and not touch it, but in my case, in this particular instance, it's not going to work. A couple of other important things to consider are the capacity of your memory card and how often you want the camera to take the time-lapse picture. I've been playing around with one picture every 60 seconds, and for an 8 to 10 hour time-lapse session, that ends up being 3 to 4 gigabytes of pictures and about 600 pictures. So if you're going to do this over several days,
It can really amount to a lot of memory and a lot of pictures. So you need to make sure your card is big enough, and you need to make sure that your computer and your software can handle that many pictures. It's kind of taxing on some computers and software, so just make sure you think that out. You don't want to take a picture every second or 5 seconds, because you'll end up with thousands of pictures. So just make sure you do the math, make sure your card's big enough, and you're not taking them too often. But anyway, that's how it works for me. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'll be happy to help out. And thank you for watching.